maximum height here, m. And then at the middle point, exactly it is having how much velocity? I think root 7 gr, root 7 gr. And the radius of the circle is how much here? R is the radius of the circle. That is what the problem I have given. And I ask you to find out, at point D, you have to find out the velocity, Vd, normal reaction at D, Nd. And also one more thing is, height of the inclination. These are you have to find out. See here, from here the mass is dropped. The mass is dropped from here, initial velocity is how much? Zero. Now, whenever it is coming here, obviously it will come with what velocity? Root 2 gh. And then it is going here with root 7 gr velocity, and then you have to find out the velocity here. Wherever the values you know, there only you consider as the initial. Understand or not? Whenever you find here, you know the value of here root 7 gr, no? Take it as an initial point. Let me take this is a point A. This is a point A and then point D. You have to apply the conservation of energy between A and D. So that what will get means you will get the velocity. For that purpose, consider again this is a zero energy level. I said already yesterday itself, for one system how many zero levels will be there? Only one will be there. That might be anywhere. You can even consider here also. But here why I did not consider nothing but here I don't know the height exactly. For that purpose only I did not consider. Even I can consider like that and then I can solve the problem also. I will solve by that also. Now potential energy is zero here. Then you have to find out the conservation of energy. You have to apply the conservation of energy between A and D. So that what will get means you will get the velocity first of all. So for that purpose energy at A is equals to energy at D. Energy at A, how many energies it is having at A? One is kinetic energy. Why? Because velocity is there. Half m into, what is the v square value? 7 gr plus, it is there some height, right? How much height it is exactly? Radius only. So that clearly what I can write here, that is mg into r. That is the kinetic energy plus potential energy at point A. Next, at point D, we don't know the velocity. Let me take the velocity is vd here. That is what I have to find out, by the way. So that to find out the vd, what you have to take? Half m into vd square kinetic energy. And the potential energy at that point is how much? 2mgr. Why? Because mg into what is the height here? 2r. So that mg into 2r is the height. Then m gets cancelled everywhere. Then here I will just cancel with r also. I can cancel. No, vd is there. No, we cannot cancel. Then 7gr plus 2gr is equals to vd square plus 4gr. Correct? Huh? Then 7 to 9 and then 9 minus 4, 5. Then vdr is equals to 5gr. Then vd is equals to what we get? Under root 5gr. This is the velocity we got. So first of all, you might be having some confusion that where you have to take the initial energy and then where you have to take the final energy. Wherever you want, you can take. You can take wherever you want. Here also you can take initial energy and then final energy, if you know the velocity there, by the way. So wherever the values you know, there only you take as initial, and then wherever you don't know that you take as final value. Okay. So that from that I got the velocity how much? Root 5gr. Now the particle is moving in this direction with root 5gr. Here by the way block is there, so that I kept the block here. Block is coming here. Now on the block, the track will apply the normal reaction in which direction? Downward direction. This is the normal reaction. And also mg also will act in which direction? Downward direction. Centrifugal force will be acting in which direction? Upward direction, radially outwards. Clear? So that clearly here what I can write, centrifugal force is equals to n plus mg. If we take reverse directions also, there is no problem. I said already in the this kind of problem already we have solved, no? So you take the different directions also, there is no problem in that. Now here normal reaction is equal to what we get here? Mg minus Fc. Mg minus, what is the Fc value we got? Mv square by r, right? M into what is the velocity here? 5gr divided by r, nothing but rr gets cancelled. What we get here? 5mg. Then normal reaction is how much here got? Minus 4mg. Minus 4mg nothing but? Fc? Right. (Clears throat) See here, n is equals to fc minus mg, right? Fc minus mg. Then this will be how much it is coming as 5gr and then minus 5g minus 5mg minus mg. So that what is answer here? 4mg is the normal reaction. I've just taken mv square by r only. That minus mg, that will give you how much normal reaction is 4mg. This is the normal reaction I got. After that, what you have to find out? You have to find out the height. Is there any relation between this circle and then this inclined plane?
Same height.
Same height, no? If same height nothing but you can say that h is equal to 2r, no? If I have given it as same height means you can say that h is equal to simply 2r. Why we will get 9r by 4 and all, 9r by 2 and all. Understanding or not? These are not same height, by the way. These are not the same height. I might be drawn like that, but it's not same height. So that there is no relation between the circle and then inclined plane. Then how to solve the problem? Again, conservation of energy only. Apply the conservation of energy at this point, initially P point let me take, and then at D point. Anywhere, otherwise you can consider here and then here also you can consider anywhere. Anywhere you can consider, wherever you want. So I am considering the energy conservation between point P and then D. Otherwise you can even consider between point P and A also. We will do that also. So that now I am considering the energy conservation. EP is equals to ED. EP, what is the energy there? At point P, what is the energy there? MGH. And along with that, kinetic energy is how much? Zero. There is no kinetic energy. So that here, MG into height of the inclined plane is H plus zero, by the way, we'll get. And then energy at D. How many energies are there at D? Two energies. One is kinetic energy. Why? Because velocity is there. Another is potential energy. So that half m into vd square plus mg into, what is the height from the ground? 2r. Then here m gets cancelled. Now this will be 2gh is equals to vd square is how much for us? Vd square is 5gr plus this will be how much? 4gr. I have taken 2 LCM at a time. Then g gets cancelled everywhere. Then h is equals to how much you'll get? 9r by 2. Why to take only P and D? Let me take P and A, we'll check. Okay. Now, energy at P is equals to energy at A. Energy at P, what is the energy there? MGH is equals to energy at A. What is the velocity here? Root 7gr. So that half m into 7gr, half mv square plus energy at A is how much here? Potential energy. How much height is there? R. So that clearly what I can write here? MGR. Then mg gets cancelled everywhere. Then h is equals to, this will be how much? 9r by 2 again. Understand or not? Otherwise, if you want to take nothing but here also you can take the velocity. Here you can take the velocity. How much velocity will be there here? Under root 2gh only, no? Under root 2gh velocity is there here. You can apply conservation of energy between these two also. Then also you get the answer. Let me check here. Kinetic energy is how much? Half mv square, right? Half m into, what is the v square value? 2gh is equals to energy at this point. Half m va, va is how much here? 7gr plus potential energy is how much? Mg into r. Now here mg gets cancelled everywhere. Then what will you get here? 2h is equals to 7r plus 2r. Where 2 cancelled? I did not cancelled. Did I do correctly only? Yes, I just cancelled 1 by 2 everywhere. Okay. Then again 2h is equals to how much? 9r. H is equals to 9r by 2. Anywhere anything is correct only. But you have to take only one zero level and along with that you have to consider the conservation of energy. You understand, right? Anywhere you can do anywhere. You can do either from here to here also. There is no problem in that. You'll get the answer. Clear everybody? Yes. Copy that. Martin. అదా నేను నేను కొడు
Venera. F is directly proportional to x power minus 1 by 4. What you have to find out there?
Power is
directly proportional.
Power is directly proportional to
power is directly proportional to x. So m is a is directly proportional. A is equal to x power minus 1 by 4. Then power is equal to force into velocity. Velocity v dv by dx is equal to x power minus 1 by 4 v dv.
X minus v square by 2 is equal to x power 3 by 4 by 3 by 4. I just took the common thing. V is directly proportional to 3 by 8 by 8.
V is directly proportional to 3 by 8. Correct. Yes. ಟೂ ಮಾಸಸ್ ಡಿಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ ನಿನ್ನೆ ಟೂ ಮಾಸಸ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಟು ಎ ರಾಡ್ ಫಿನಿಶ್ನು ಬೇಡ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ದೆನ್ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ದಟ್ ಅ ಕಾರ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ A car moving over a convex bridge is lighter than same car resting on the same bridge. Same car resting on the same bridge. See that they are saying that prove that a car moving over a convex bridge is lighter than the same car resting on the same bridge. We have to prove that how it will be lighter and all. Now it will come for the theory questions, by the way. In that theory questions they will ask that whenever it is in rest then it will be more weighter, otherwise when it is rest more lighter. Like that they will ask, otherwise when it is there at the exactly top point at that time it will be more lighter. That and all theory questions they will ask. So only we have to prove that. Now here convex bridge is nothing but like this bridge will be there. Now at this point a car is moving, let me take. At this point car is moving. So for example, however it is like inclined plane only, no? It is inclined plane only. Now here it is moving upwards, nothing but velocity will be there in this direction. And also whenever it is moving on the circular plane only, this one is circular motion, nothing but what force will be there for us? Centrifugal force will be there. So that centrifugal force is there radially outwards, Fc. And also mg is there in which direction? Downward direction. Mg is there in the downward direction. And then the component of mg opposite to the normal reaction is what? Mg cos theta on the inclined plane. Mg cos theta. And also here normal reaction will be there in which direction? Upward direction. That is about the diagram. And then they are saying that it is having more weight or less weight, nothing but who will give apparent weight here? Normal reaction will give apparent weight. I said in the lift problems only. Always, for example, anything hanging for the string means tension will give you the apparent weight. Otherwise anybody standing in the lift, otherwise they are just moving on some surface, nothing but then normal reaction will give apparent weight. And also yesterday you might be solved that one pilot is rotating in the circular motion with the plane like that they have given, no? So in that what will give the apparent weight? Nothing but it will, that net up thrust force will give the apparent weight. Whenever the you might be seeing the military stunts also, they'll be rotating like that. So whenever they are rotating in the vertical circle, then who will give the net weight? Nothing but the upthrust on the plane will give the net weight. Instead of that you just consider that as a string only, that is a string, and then a pendulum only you consider.
then who will give the apparent weight? Nothing but tension will give the apparent weight. The same thing you do there also. So here also, whenever the body is there in contact with the ground, otherwise contact with the surface, at that time normal reaction will give you the apparent weight. Now first case, what they are saying, nothing but you have to prove the weight relation between whenever the body is in rest on the bridge, otherwise whenever the body is moving on the bridge. Two cases you have to take. One case is moving, another is in rest. Same position you can take. Now the body is moving, nothing but radially outward centrifugal force will be acting. Why? Because this is a convex bridge they have given. This is a convex shape, right? You might be seen in the ray optics also. Concave, nothing but bridge should be like this. Okay. Then here downwards mg is acting, and then you can take it as a inclined plane only. Then it is acting as how much here? Mg cos theta. Now velocity is there in this direction, so the centrifugal force, and it is there in contact with the surface, nothing but normal reaction is acting in the upward direction. I said who will give the apparent weight here? Normal reaction, always, always normal reaction. Tension, you might be seen in the spring problems in the loss of motion. I said who will give the apparent weight? Nothing but tension will give. We did not discuss F is equals to kx there. I said only tension, so that there tension will give you the reading. Here normal reaction will give you the reading. In lift problems also normal reaction will give you the reading. Whenever you see in the water, for example, you are putting a block in the water, nothing but force of buoyancy will give you the reading. And also whenever the flight is just rotating in the vertical circle in the air, at that time upthrust will give you the reading. So instead of upthrust, you can take that as a tension only. In the fluids chapter also, you can take that is also like tension only. Why? Because it will act upwards, obviously. And also in these cases, whichever is there in contact with the surface, at that time you can take normal reaction as the apparent weight. Now here, at this point, vertically the body is in equilibrium. In this direction, the body is in equilibrium. So what I can write here? Fc plus n is equals to what I can write? Mg cos theta. Then n is equals to what I can write? Mg minus Fc. Whatever the Fc might be, Mg minus, what is the velocity I have given? V, so that mv square by r. This is the normal reaction I got. When it is? Whenever the car moving, otherwise in rest. Mg cos theta only, no? I have written. Right.